I pulled off the 15 freeway here in Yermo, California, to a place where I have never been and I personally have never seen. This is a place called Liberty Sculpture Park. And this was built on a piece of land that somebody bought back in 2017. And they put some sculptures and artwork out here. It's pretty neat. It's kind of pretty close to Peggy Sue's Diner, if you've ever been here. It's about 2.5 miles east on Yermo Road, I believe. Pretty cool. So we're out here at Liberty Sculpture Park. We're going to take a look and see what it's all about. Hope you enjoy. In 2017, a group of friends, including Weiming Chen, a Chinese-born dissident and sculptor, bought 36 acres of desert next to the I-15 freeway. Chen christened it Liberty Sculpture Park and told the reporters that its purpose was to champion the human desire for freedom and condemn the oppression of Chinese communism. Artwork chosen for the park would be visible every day to thousands of passing motorists on the interstate. All artists were invited to contribute, but for now, only Chen's work is standing in the desert. So this is apparently the first piece of artwork that was put out here. It's called The Origin of Freedom. Number one, Chief Crazy Horse, unveiled on December 11th, 2017. It was the first sculpture erected out here, manifesting a tacit truth: freedom shall not be dictated by any people. The Origin of Freedom, number one, Chief Crazy Horse. Sculpture, Weiming Chen. It's pretty cool. Well, let's start over here at the farthest point and we'll work our way back and see what kind of cool stuff is out here. So a lot of these signs are in Chinese and some of them are, they're mentioning the CCP virus. In fact, quite a few of them are. And out here, the Chinese Communist Party is the CCP, and apparently this is an anti-communism, pro-democracy place out here. Some of the signs are interesting. This one looks like it could possibly be the Chinese leader with an X in front of the Hitler. It looks like a Chinese Hitler, so Chinese can't kill us all. Free Hong Kong, boycott Mulan. This is a really interesting place to visit. Here's a little wall mural that says, Free Hong Kong, revolution now. Interesting. I'm going to have to look up and see what the significance is of all of the umbrellas, the yellow umbrellas. This statue says on the flag, Free Hong Kong, revolution. There's a bunch of painted plaques out here as well. Some finger molds, hand molds. Interesting. It's a woman holding the flag. And some soldiers, it look like they have gas masks on. Here's another statue over here. Let's check it out. There's a sign that says, I shall never yield, even if I am to be beheaded. It's a statue of Li Wenyang, put here on June 6, 2018. One of his One of his quotes is, "Everyone is responsible for the fate of the nation, and I will not yield, even if I am to be beheaded for an early realization of democracy and a multi-party system in China." He was awarded the Free Spirit Prize on June 4th, 2012 by the Independent Federation of Chinese Students and Scholars. 2 days later, on June 6th, 2012, he was found dead by his relatives hanging from the window of a hospital. He was murdered at the hands of the Chinese Communist Party. Hey everybody, this is the sculptor of all these great pieces of art out here. He's just telling me how this sculpture was burnt down by the Chinese Communist Party.
You know, the CCP violence here, and here the map is, you know, what's happened, the COVID-19 is from China, the regional, okay? So this is Chinese government no care about this. Then the airplane to all world, to American, to Europe, you know. And this time they know this is very dangerous, very serious dangerous. Mm-hmm. But they cut off all the airline in the China. No to Beijing, no to Shanghai, no to another city. But they are the airplane to American, airplane to Europe.
Right.
Then the Trump want to stop it. They complain, oh, you are racism, you know. Mm-hmm. You want, why you stop our Chinese airline to overseas, you know. The union say this no problem, you know. The guy, you know, say no any problem. But after the problem for whole the world. So we as Chinese, I think this is trouble from the Chinese government.
Yeah, this used to be a big head, right? It
looked like very big. You can, in the internet, you can see the CCP virus, the image, okay?
Oh, I'm so sorry this
guy. Yeah, so we established in the June 4th. June 4th is Tiananmen massacre's 32 years. And anniversary.
Wow.
So we established the statue here. Now after around 1 month, not 2 months, you know.
Right.
They first want to destroy, use the gin, you know, want to tear down the statue. But too heavy, you know, too stronger, connected with the base. So no way, they cut off the piece. Go home to research what's the material.
Wow.
You know, this is fiberglass.
Fiberglass.
Yeah, so fiberglass, the second time they come back and then burn it.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
Thank you for doing this.
June 4th, the happening is from now, 32 years ago, the Tiananmen Square, the Chinese government killed more than 5,000 people.
5,000 people.
Yeah, killed the student and the citizen. Because they want the democracy in the China, want the freedom. They peaceful protest in the Tiananmen Square, you know. But they use the tank, you know, the tank man, you know. They use the tank.
And I see the man standing in front of the tank.
Yeah,
yeah.
They
killed
so many people.
Oh my goodness.
So I'm an sculptor. I was, you know, my friend buy the piece of land, 36 acre. We would like to make the sculpture park. Mm-hmm. This sculpture park is a liberty sculpture park for hold the statue, hold the art work. Uh-huh. Should be freedom, human right, and democracy.
Amen.
This because in the world, you know, have so many sculpture park for love, for second war, first war, Vietnamese war, Korea war, you know, so many very good sculpture park. So now I would like with my friend, you know.
Thank you for doing what you do. People in this country need to be reminded that this is America,
because
it's a land of freedom.
This is, you know, the you know, the Chinese government how to evil.
Yeah.
In the American, you can see anything. You can see this is Trump problem. You can see Biden's problem. Nobody stop your voice. nobody stop you create art.
Right.
But you know, I created this art piece. The Chinese government just use burn, fire. This is attack American soil. This is American land.
Right.
They in the 6 o'clock daytime, they just burn.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for doing what you've done out here, sir.
Okay, thank you.
God bless you.
Okay.
God bless the Chinese people. And may everybody have freedom.
God bless America.
Absolutely. We love you guys.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Bye-bye. Wow, what a treat. What a treat that was. We actually got to meet the sculptor that made all of these beautiful pieces of art. And I can't believe the Chinese Communist Party burnt down his sculpture out here. Even in America, they have reach. You know, God bless that man for what he's doing. It's all about liberty, freedom, and we are so lucky in this country that we have what we have. Let's check out some of the other artwork he's made out here. This looks like a Chinese troop carrier he's got sitting out here. Wow. There's a little Chinese building. Little reconstruction. And here's a tank. It's a sculpture of a Chinese tank with a gentleman standing here, as they did in China, to stop the Chinese Communist Party. And understand the Chinese massacre of Tiananmen Square happened on 6/4, 30 plus years ago. Fascinating. Well, this little pavilion here, it's called the Zhengquang Pavilion, and it's dedicated to all those who died from the Chinese Communist Party virus, especially to the memory of Ding Zhengquang, a native of Shanghai and a devout Christian, to offer shelter to Ding's soul, shade to our companions, and for the benefit of everyone. May it stand tall in the desert as a prayer to God and a blessing on America. May the torch of the goddess of democracy burn bright and lead the people out of darkness. Wow, so this is a Elvis boy. What a fantastic experience this has been. Liberty Sculpture Park. I cannot believe we got a chance to meet the artist that made all of these sculptures, Chen Weiming. Chen Weiming, thank you. Thank you for reminding us of how good we have it here, the liberty that we have here. And reminding us that there are people in the rest of the world that aren't experiencing this freedom like we do. I know there's a lot of things going on here in this country right now, but America is still great. It's the greatest country on earth. Everyone wants to come here to experience this liberty that we have. Wow. So again, I remind you that you need to live big, love big, embrace all of the positive things in life, things that make you feel good. Cast aside all of those negative things, the things that make you feel bad. Please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. I really would like to reach more people with this message of just seeking joy and casting aside the bad things in life. People need to hear this message. So, again, I say, life is too short for anything but joy. This is Elvis Boy from Liberty Sculpture Park in Yermo, California. God bless you, and I'll see you next time.